Despite the often scary headlines, this summer is shaping up to be a big one for travel. It seems a strong dollar and cheaper airline fares trump terrorism fears, as popular destinations are already seeing summer bookings fill up. Here with the story is WSJ Middle Seat columnist Scott McCartney. Hi, Scott. Great to see you.
Good to be with you, Tanya.
So, Scott, in the wake of the Brussels bombing, this is certainly welcome news. I had assumed that that event would have had a severe dampening effect on travel to Europe, but that's not the case.
Yeah, it's not the case. Actually, historically, tourism has obviously taken a major hit from terrorist attacks, but regularly bounces back quickly. And the Brussels attacks, horrible as they were, it's been interesting in the travel business. Brussels is mostly a business destination, not so much a leisure destination. And the other factors in travel this summer, the strong dollar and really significantly lower airfare, it's just making it an appealing proposition despite the unrest.
That's so great. And so how about Paris? Has tourism there rebounded entirely at this point?
I wouldn't say entirely, but significantly, to a great extent. Travelport, which is a company that does runs booking systems for airlines, hotels, all kinds of travel vendors, they say worldwide visitors into Paris for summer will be about down about 7% compared to last year, but it's a significant rebound from what happened in Paris in November.
Certainly glad to hear that. Now, Scott, is there one area of the world, though, where terrorism fears appear to have stuck?
Yeah, I think Turkey is probably falls into that category. Travel into Istanbul was booming. Turkish Airlines was growing significantly, and there's just been a series of attacks there that have caused Europeans and lots of others to avoid going to Turkey for now.
That's too bad. Let's hope that changes. But looking at the good side of the travel news, where are the areas that seem to be most in demand? Are some of those off the beaten track parts of Europe seeming very popular?
Yeah, I think there is some effect from terrorism in generating interest in sort of lesser known, more out of the way destinations. People who travel into Portugal, for example, is way up. The currency, the strength of the dollar helps significantly. Virtuoso, which is a network of luxury travel agencies, they say that bookings this year into Portugal are up 88%.
Wow.
Ireland is up 58%. Places where people feel like they're not going to run into trouble, those are growing significantly. So we've seen a lot of that, but you know, the airfare into London, Rome, Paris, other major destinations where you always get lots of people, running about 10% less this year than at the same time last year. And so obviously people are scooping up those bargains as
Absolutely.
Well.
Absolutely. That sounds encouraging. So are hotels in popular areas already booking up? Are the rooms more expensive?
They are and they aren't. So they're definitely booking up. I talked to Virtuoso, who said, the Amalfi Coast of Italy, always extremely popular already for summer. Most of the rooms are booked. Looked on Expedia, and about all you can get is a suite for a couple $1,000s at high season in July, that kind of thing. I think hotel rates are up. The impact is muted for Americans because of the strength of the dollar. So you convert those rates from euros or pounds into dollars, and it's not so bad. But some of the high-end hotels are apparently requiring prepayment and even imposing 45 to 60 day cancellation windows, even though, for rooms in London during Wimbledon or things like that,
wow,
they know they're going to resell them, but still imposing some major restrictions.
All right, Scott, great information. I guess we better start planning those summer vacations before all the good rooms are gone. Thank you so much for that.
Sure.